the audience here. Who is actually from Dallas? Anybody? Who is from Texas in general? How would you feel about knowing that an important part of Texas history, specifically Dallas history, is soon to be lost? As a country today, we have been fixated on kind of destroying our past and shunning it for what it is. We do have a darker past, yet it doesn't conform to that American image today. Because of that very reason, we're overlooking one of the most influential parts of American history, specifically the Great Depression. However, as we youth, the class in general today, we embody the future and the possibility of change. We can change the fact of how our history is viewed, specifically by starting with the bad side of Bonnie and Clyde. And so the preservation in terms of Dallas history, which is really Texas history and American history, is actually is greater than before, because currently the two buildings are being under the direct threat of being torn down. So you may ask why these two buildings are actually important. Well, I'm going to go answer that by showing you our remains of their history today. So these are the two buildings that I'm currently discussing, which is Henry Rose Filling Station, gas station, and then Bonnie Parker's Elementary School. So these are the two buildings in question. However, what I'm speaking about today is the remains of their history right now, which is, the first one is Joplin, Missouri. In April 1933, there was a shootout that left two law enforcement officers dead, which actually, this is the only extant building still standing other than the two in question here. And it's actually listed on the National Register of Historic Places, and it's been preserved to the way it was it would appear during the Bear Gang's occupation here. The other places are essentially sites. I don't know if any of you know that is familiar with Wellington. It's not far from here, which Clyde actually drove his car off the side of an embankment into a river in June of 1933. And then there's also Grapevine, which the people in Dallas, you might know. In April 1934, they shot and killed two law enforcement officers just outside of Grapevine. And then the most famous is the Gibson, Louisiana ambush site in May 1934, which is also preserved today. So, as you may see, there's no beginning to where all of this story. Those two buildings are the beginning of the story. They start in April 1933 and go to May 1934, but what about the other part? The Depression hit in 29. And so from there, there's no justification there. And so you may ask, though, why a criminal's homes should be preserved. Well, I'm going to answer that by another example that actually I recently come across, which is the farm and childhood home of Jesse James. Y'all, it's actually preserved. So it represents not necessarily just Civil War history, not necessarily just Jesse James history, but outlaw culture in a way, and also the surrounding time of the Civil War and post the Reconstruction era after the Civil War, and the turmoil that followed it. So, in comparison, I'm looking at preserving these because they're not only representing Bonnie and Clyde history, but they also represent Depression era history, Texas history, and American history, which is all your history. So, there's a simple solution to this. But then again, it revolves around the restoration. So the first step is turning the buildings over to local Dallas area high schools, even universities, to restore. But again, it's restoration. The second one is to apply for Texas Historical Commission marker, as you saw in Wellington. But again, they cannot be restored, marked without restoration. They need to appear as they were, just as you see here. So, and the last one is turning them into a museum focusing on the Great Depression, and one of which we actually don't have. Every museum has their own display, maybe, or exhibition of the Great Depression, but not necessarily a museum solely focusing on that. I'd like to quote here a man by the name of James Johnston. He runs a site called Vanishing Texas. And he's quoted as saying, "The area is being revitalized, and if the wrong person purchases the property, it could be torn down for something more modern. If and when that happens, that would be another piece of Bonnie Clyde history to be lost to history." So, essentially, speed is the key here, and this is where your help comes in. I'm currently looking for donations to restore the buildings, in which you will receive a t-shirt in return to show what you have done. You can display and wear your pride, wear the actions of preserving American history proudly in hopes that somebody comes and asks you what you've done. You can tell them, "I not only saved history, but also provided students a possibility to learn about the Great Depression, and also gave future historic preservationists the opportunity to actually have hands-on experience, which hopefully will in turn contextualize the Great Depression for the rest of the general American public." through Lonnie and Clyde. So, in ending, I want to quote here a man by the name of Ken Holmes. He's the owner of the Lonnie and Clyde Ambush Museum in Gainesville, Louisiana. He has stated as having said, when discussing the cemetery where Clyde is buried, it needs to be unlocked. People from all over the world come to see that grave. So why not the beginning, too, these buildings? They are associated specifically with Bonnie and Clyde, but also in a larger context of the Great Depression. People from all around the world come to see the story as fascinating because it is uniquely Texan and uniquely American. As Americans, we need to begin to embrace our history and uniqueness, both good and bad, because it is our identity. This acceptance can only be achieved, though, if there is a starting point, started by you, here through with the story of Bonnie and Clyde.